Periscope online. YouTube online. Periscope producer, preview broadcast. Going live with Periscope. Hello, Periscope. Facebook is next. YouTube should already be online. Live on Facebook, live on YouTube. Hello, YouTube. Hello, Facebook. Right on my back. Alright. So, I'll be painting a panda bear. Doing a bigger canvas than normal, so I had a lot of masking to do. Gonna finish masking up real quick, and then I'm gonna start with the background and move into the foreground tonight, and then probably the next broadcast after this, I'll be painting the actual panda bear. So, and since it's a big canvas, it's going to be a long project, but it'll be fun. I like panda bears. So, I'm running low on my automotive tape and Coast. It's pretty pricey to buy from so I try to only order from Coast once or twice a year, unless I'm making good money, then I'll order from them more when I do get a lot of work. But usually, I'm just breaking even, so. Use this masking tape I get from Big Lots. It's not as professional as the automotive tape, but. Does the job. And I always end up using it on these big projects. People laugh at me. When I did the big old white tiger I did, I did it with like a million pieces of this tape. People were laughing at me. It's okay. Got a thick skin. Sometimes, you know, as artists, we wear our emotions on our sleeves. But I've toughened up over the years. pandas are fun. I use a little bit of this too, because didn't realize that his arm came around. I'm just taping off the areas that I don't want background color on. And I'm not going to follow the photograph exactly again. At least not when it comes to background. And the foreground, I'm adding some stuff to the foreground too. But the panda reference. You know, I apologize to the photographers out there too. You know, I go on Pinterest and Google and everything else. And use your references for paintings, but I just don't have access to a zoo. I tell my kids to bring me books all the time with animals, with animal pictures from school, and they forget. But I've been wanting to paint a panda, and I was recently asked about a panda painting in Mar Vista. My last show, I got asked if I had any pandas on me. I go through phases where I'll paint a lot of animals and then I'll stop. And I'll come back to it. And I really do like painting. Yeah, Panda. Panda, Panda. Have you heard that rapper Panda? He's like a trap rapper. The song is super catchy though, it just says Panda over and over. Panda, 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 Panda. I did a lot of the cutting beforehand, but I still had left some work. And I did this cutting. I prepared this while I was painting the cat. So don't think just because I'm taking long on a project that I'm sitting on my butt. I'm doing other things too. Try to stay ready. Multitasking. I don't like to paint two paintings at the same time. I know artists that do that. That would drive me nuts. I'd rather finish one and then move on to the next. But I will prepare and get ready for my next project, start looking for references and stuff. But I threw everything at this thing. I got like this construction paper right here, or painter's paper, and for painting houses. I also use this paper to cover up my, when I send a painting to a client through the mail, I'll wrap it in this stuff first. I had on this, I just painted over this canvas, that's why I'm going to use it. I had a big Game of Thrones painting on it, but it never sold, and it didn't get like interest. Like I could tell like people weren't interested in it when, and you know, I thought Game of Thrones was popular and people, you know, would want a Game of Thrones painting, but it just wasn't doing anything for anybody. So sometimes you gotta paint over stuff. So we got the Mother of Dragons underneath all this white paint. But now we're going to have a cool panda, and people will be interested in the panda because I've already been asked about pandas. Gotta make that money. just like everybody else. They go to work, they expect to make money. I do this. And I'm not just doing it for my health. I expect to make money. I hope to make money. You can't even expect, I hope to make money, but. It's a rough game. It's not easy. Gotta pay your dues, and nobody helps you out in this game, so if anybody's watching that wants to be an artist, just know that other artists aren't gonna stick their necks out to help you. Occasionally they will, you know, if they have something for you that, you know, I've had some of my friends help me from around town. Mark Goddard, Clifford Morris, Cat Taps, Alex gave me my start. Alexander P. Huerta gave me my start here in town at his gallery. People throw you bones here and there, but don't expect it. Don't expect other artists to just come out, and you gotta do the work, you know? And ISI Group has also helped me out a lot. Most of my experience has come from doing their shows. That's where I really got over my fear of doing things live or, you know, as soon as I started doing this, you know, I knew I wasn't ready to do it. But, you know, I had to eat, you know, and I was always real nervous. Like, I even got jobs like drawing caricatures and stuff on the strip, and I would leave them. I would just get up and walk away because I'd freak out, you know, having people watch me draw. I used to hide and draw. When I was going to the Art Institute, the teachers would be like, you guys need to get up in the front of the class. I would hide in the corner. I don't want people to see what I was drawing, how I was drawing it. I would just freak out. It would just freak me out. You know, me racing, is every time I raced, I would feel like all self-conscious, you know? But, I got through it. Thanks, the ISI Group helped me out a lot with that, because all the live painting I did at the Link, and every time I would go, things would just go a little better for me, you know? So, big props to them, Dana, Phil. So this is what I'm going to do. I think I'm going to do like a blue sky maybe with some greens and yellows. We'll see though. I'm trying to get this thing to work. I think I got to turn up the pressure. It's a big gun for the background. So I still got a little sound coming from my compressor, but I've eliminated a lot of it. A lot of the noise that I had in here. and I figured out what kind of music I can get away with for a time, because they still come after me every once in a while for the music, which is dumb. Bad boy out. I haven't used it in a while. I bought it so I wouldn't have to use as many spray cans. I think I'm going to go away from using spray cans in the future. Just bad for the environment. Freaking ozone layer. Can't say you care about the environment and use spray cans. So, yeah, it's gonna be a big project. We'll take it one step at a time. And, starting with the big guns. I used to do time-lapse videos. I thought people would have shorter attention spans, but I feel like those don't really show the process. I thought with people's short attention spans, a time lapse would be better. Just making sure this gun doesn't clog on me. Looks like it has some dried paint in here. It's been a while since I used it. But on these big projects, I don't like to sit there with a little cup. I mean, look at the different size of cups, you know. Let's see how that works. It's like a loser to work. No, maybe not. Check the pressure real quick in the compressor. cable came loose out over there. I think because I was tugging on it. Alright, now we'll find the blue. Basket that I use for Kurgo. For my paints. Some white. Shake it all up. Here we go. Some light coat. Let me open the window because this is going to make a lot of dust. To open my windows too much because I don't like the neighbors to have to hear my noise at night, you know. They can deal with it for an hour or two. Come on, guy. I swear my little gun clogs less than this. Every time I try to use it, it's the same deal. There we go. So background, then foreground. And then, I like that too. I like that soft, misty lip. So yeah, I don't really have a lot of experience using this gun. I bought it from Urals, and then I just ended up using spray paint. But I want to get away from using as much spray paint as I have in the past and start using more guns. So yeah, the picture, there's no blue there. I'm gonna put my own background, my own foreground. Because I'm not painting just to copy pictures. I'm not a copy machine. I like to do my own thing. Have fun with it, you know? This is what Bob Ross would have wanted. Oh yeah, I like that. I like that. So I'm gonna leave it like that, nice and misty. Nice effect. Paint the sides. There's a gallery wrap. So I've been painting mainly on boards, on Masonite boards. But this one's also a Masonite board, same type of Masonite board as this one. But it's a gallery wrap. It's got a thick side, so I'm going to paint the sides really good. But yeah, I've been doing that for time's sake. Because sitting there building boards isn't fun.
Right.
It's nice and dusty in here now.
Stuff will give you tuberculosis.
Hang this gun up.
Change it.
Next up, let this dry a little bit, and then I'm gonna paint in my foreground stuff that I added. I gotta look up a reference for bamboo, because I added some bamboo that's not on the picture. So my plan is, hopefully it works, to have a little bit of leaves and stuff, bamboo leaves, in the foreground. And a piece of bamboo up front. But like I said, I gotta look up a piece of bamboo just to get the textures on it. Just so I'm not making it up. The only bad thing about this tape is it sticks like a mother. It's like a Christmas present. This X-Acto blade, put your finger anywhere near it, it'll cut it off. But it can't cut paper. Yeah, it's gonna be a big boy. Hopefully I get it done quick. That I get for using this cheap stuff, but it's seemed like a good idea at the time. My pencil smearing. If you don't want pencil to smear, spray some fixative on it. The only time it really smears is when I freehand draw. Because of the erasing and everything. Christmas present. What else do I got here? Some leaves. Yeah, I'll get some more leaves here. Save this paper. Take all this off. Boring start, not a lot of painting, more mostly cutting, but it's necessary evil. Tonight, that's mostly what I'll be doing. Probably won't even see the panda get started tonight. Just prepping still and I made a mess out of this stencil, but I'll get it figured out. I used to hate cutting, doing a lot of stencil work and cutting. I would try to do as much freehand as I could. Still do, but I do more cutting now than ever. Freehand for the win. It looks like I've got a big old mess right now, but somewhere in my mind I know what I'm doing. I'm not really worried too much about overspray with the leaves in this area because the panda is black, so it's where his arm is at, so the blackness of his arm will be able to fill in over that overspray. Yeah, rough start here, rough beginning. Get it worked out. My main goal is not to have it look like I just copied the poor photographer's panda picture, but in the end, it'll probably still be noticeable that it's the same picture. Can't really do anything about that, but the other stuff should give it a cool little touch. I got so many references for pandas when I was looking them up that I kind of regretted choosing this one. I wanted another one. So I might do some more pandas pretty soon. Probably gonna take a break from animals after this one. I got every kind of spray in here right now. I smell like I got that fixative stink, and I got the that spray from the blue that I put still there. So yeah, I'm pretty hating life right now. That's all of the leaves though after this. There we go. That worked out. Alright. And I do want to mask that up. And I apologize to anybody who's not understanding what I'm doing right now, but it all come together in the end, I promise. this is just a little shield. A little overspray shield. It doesn't always work. Sometimes it still gets past it. That's my fault. Not the tapes. A lot of taping, a lot of cutting. And airbrushing is still a faster process than painting with the paintbrush. I know because I've done both. My favorite traditional media, and it's a lot like airbrush, it's the closest thing to airbrush, is pastels and charcoals. That's in traditional art, that's the closest thing that you'll get to airbrush. Except you don't have to use as much masking. But the softness of it, it's like painting with, I mean, it's like drawing with smoke. And that's what I like the most about it. Airbrushing is like painting with smoke. I haven't been airbrushing that long. I was traditional painting. When I first stepped out on the scene, all my paintings were done with acrylic and paintbrush. Then I started airbrushing a little bit more and a little bit more. Started liking the speediness of it. I didn't like that airbrush had that stigma attached to it. Of being like a carnival thing or only for vehicles and stuff like that, that bugged me. But I got over it. Decided I was gonna do what I wanted. I don't care what other people think, and the rest is history. So. pencil marks, they show up. So try to erase them and make them as light as I can, because they come through the paint not, and that's my pet peeve. Airbrush paint is so transparent. There we go, so piece of bamboo there, leaves up here, I'll get a cut. So what's going to happen tonight is I'm going to finish up this foreground and then call it a night, and then tomorrow, or not tomorrow actually, next time I stream, I'll make sure that the panda gets work done. I was watching a stencil artist, some show on Netflix about art, I forgot what it was, and he was saying how he had to control his breathing when he cut with an X-Acto. I'm like, come on guy, it's not that hard. So dramatic. So dramatic, you guys. So I got my camera far back as I can, so when I stand, if it cuts my head off, then I will. So now I gotta mix a decent green for these leaves. Got some mystery green mixed too. Purple. Definitely be putting some purple on these leaves, but at the end. Teachers to freak out about me not putting purple on leaves. Our teachers are always telling us how leaves also have purple. And... Alright. They also have green. I have to mix my own. So I'm not seeing what I like here. Needs a different tone of yellow. The progress so far.
A little bit of this golden yellow here.
Side of Panda's cheek turning green right there. That's gonna come back and bite me later. Well, actually, it's not. It's the side of his palm. I'm good. Still gonna mask it a little bit. Put it on super dark. Don't saturate the hell out of it. So this is basically blocking them in, and then as the painting goes on, I'll detail them more. But I don't need masking there for every single piece of detail, every single thing I paint, you know. Missed a leaf here. I'm not worried about overspray here because there's a. It's gonna be mainly black. What I don't want to overspray is like here in the blue. It might still get some anyway. I want some green back there anyway. I might put some like greens and yellows back there later. Bamboo has a little bit of green on it. So let's put some green down there. I want to make something cool, so hopefully this comes out the way I imagined it. Pour this green out. This yellow is going to become a new green. New green container. I mix a lot of greens. So I have a lot of containers with greens that I saved but didn't label. Mystery greens that I never use again. Got some bamboo here. So it looks like I'm gonna start with the brown. Thank you. liking this brown, but I'm gonna use it anyway because I'm gonna use it just as one layer. Yeah, I don't like the brown too much. Golden bamboo. These are just the first passes here. Let's see if we can do with this bamboo. Alright, let's start filling up some of this tape. Just like Christmas. Got a cute little panda under here. Thank you. saw that tape. Does not want to let go.
Taking all this stuff off because it's blinding me. It served its purpose. Blocking things in for me, so. I want to see what I'm painting. No more tape. No more tape. We'll do it live. I like this, bro. That's what I'm talking about right here. Thank you to Hector Gets Busy. If you watch this or if you watch the replay, you gave me this Spectre text like 4 years ago. Good stuff, though. I'm liking this brown. Mocha. Jacob Brown. Thank you, Hector. Came through for me again, man. Came through for me again, homeboy. Do it live. Need some more leaves there. I ain't scared, homie. I don't fear failure or rejection. We're gonna go to about 11 o'clock. I'm gonna keep it short and sweet. Cause I am gonna be doing a lot of this. We've been working on this for a while, so. So yeah, I'm definitely gonna be layering this more, making this look nice and neat. So now we're gonna leave a little bit more. A little bit.
probably half the show watching me clean my brush. I like the way Bob Ross used to clean his brushes. He just did a little smack against the side of it. Beat the devil out of it, he said. Just beat the devil out of it. Can't beat the devil out of the airbrush, though. Beat the devil out of it. All right, some green. Battery ran out of the music. No more music. Yeah, that's it back there. Golden yellow, a little white. Make it all right. Yeah, let's see what I got. Looks good. Looks good. These leaves are going to be an ongoing thing, so. Tape. That's why my shield's for. I like a little bit of green on the down blue. I used to go to this park in Redlands, California. That was filled with that blue. I forgot what it's called. I think it was called Prospect Park. We used to go there and smoke weed. Shit was fun as hell. Filled with down blue. It was like smoking weed in a Zen garden. Back when smoking weed would have put you in jail. They say, why do people get paranoid from smoking weed? Well, I know why we used to get paranoid, because that's the popo would come bust us. Some blue back there. I could just dump some tape residue back. Looks like that's where we're gonna stop tonight. I got about 10 more minutes, so paint for a little bit longer. Some blue there. Some blue.
but that's about as far as I'm going to go with the piece, as far as progress. I'm just going to do a little bit of cleanup work, and then tomorrow, or next time I stream, continue with this piece. Now, music wasn't very good tonight, but at least I had music. Some blue back there. Some more blue up top, I think. So it's working out. I'm not hating the bamboo on the bottom yet. Still might put some passes on it though. Some more darks and some more lights. All this green before I put the blue in here. Get it. Still, the color stored in my big gun, so. Put a drop of white in it. Drop a reducer. Process. You gotta respect the process. Or it'll shit on you.
right. All right, that's where we're leaving it tonight, guys. Thanks for tuning in if you tuned in. And if you're watching the replay, thank you for watching the replay. Periscope, Facebook, YouTube, thank all of my viewers. Checking me out, my family members who came and supported me. I love you guys. If you're watching on YouTube, like and subscribe. If you're watching on Facebook and you have a YouTube account, please like and subscribe on my YouTube. The link, should be in my description. Now it's on my description on Instagram. Follow me on Instagram at LuisMo101, L-U-I-S-M-O-101. And I'm out. Thank you, guys.